¿Sabes español?
Okay, thanks for having me.
All right, I'm recording.
Sí.
Ah, excelente, muchas gracias.
En español solamente.
Ya nadie está
hablando. Pero hay gente que no puede
hablando.
Entender.
Perfecto, es lo mejor que podemos hacer.
Solo metemos dos.
Okay, sorry, I'm sorry. Okay, so your screen now, Emma? Or are you recording?
I'm recording.
Perfect, good to know. So we are going to start. I'm not going to be able to see like anyone's faces, and that's a black screen. Okay. So, hello everyone. We have Monica Rial over here. She's not only a voice actress. Of course, you know, Nano is one of the most popular characters of the show. And well, I'm going to let Monica again introduce herself.
Hi everybody, I am Monica Rial, and I am the voice of Nano. She's adorable. I can't tell you how happy I was to be cast as Nano, and in such a cute show. Nichijou is just adorable. I can't tell you how much fun that, especially Jade and I, Jade Saxton, who plays Hakase, we had so much fun working on this show. It was just an absolute blast. So I'm excited to talk to you guys today. It's going to be awesome.
Excellent.
So,
good to know. So let's start with the first question. This one's by Clayton, and he says, "Other than Nano, what other characters do you like in Nichijou, major or minor?"
I honestly can't think of a character in Nichijou that I don't like. Like, I think that it's so well written. The characters are all so well rounded. I'm going to have to go with My Little Family, though, because I spend the most time with Hakase and Sakamoto. I adore Sakamoto. In fact, Anthony Bowling, who plays Sakamoto, he actually, we were in another show called Urahara, and he played my little shrimp sidekick. So it was really fun. Like, the next show we go into was Nichijou, and it's like, oh, hey, now I'm your cat sidekick. I'm like, this is awesome. But I really love Hakase, and I love what Jade did with Hakase, because she's cute, she's a little annoying, because, you know, kids are annoying, but she was absolutely precious, and so I just wanted to snuggle her all the time. I'm like, I just want to take Hakase and love on her, so she's definitely my favorite other than Nano, I would say. But Sakamoto is a close second. Hakase is pretty cool.
Sakamoto's incredible, yeah. Okay, so, this one by Volatile. And they say, I love how your version of Nano's voice is astoundingly near to the originals, including her little vocal dispositions and gasps. The English dub of Nichijou has honestly surprised me, since I didn't really expect Nano's dub voice to be so good. But here we are. How did you emulate this? Good job, by the way.
Hard. You know, I've been doing this for such a long time. I've been a voice actor since the late 90s. That'll age me. So it's one of those things that I'm always so thankful for any opportunity I get to actually work on a role. Like, it's still so surreal to me that this is my job, this is my life. When this show came along, there were just so many cute characters, so many different characters I wanted to audition for. But there was something about Nano, kind of because she's a maternal figure, even though she's cute and young, she's still so worried about everybody and takes care of everybody, and that is me to a T. And I know that we always try to take a little bit of ourselves and put it into that character, so that was really easy with me with Nano. But also when I listen to the Japanese seiyuu, I always try to emulate something about their voice in my own voice. And I was pretty surprised when I heard this seiyuu, because I'm like, oh wow, we do sound pretty similar as is. So it made that job even easier to kind of give her that sweet, kind of higher, nicer tone. But she's just an adorable sweetheart, and it was so great to be able to step into her shoes and to kind of go through all of her different torments. You know, every time she tries to do something and her arm shoots off, or, you know, the poor girl just can't catch a break. She's trying so hard. So there was definitely a lot in my lifetime that I could kind of apply to Nano, which made her even more relatable to me But thank you. That's a huge compliment to say that. We are always very concerned about, you know, what the fandom's gonna think, because, you know, we try so hard to capture the original intent of the Japanese and just make it English, and we hope that that's what we're doing. So to do something like that means a lot. So thank you.
It's impressive because it's a really old show.
I'm dabbing.
Yeah, she's dabbing.
Yeah, you know, we were surprised that it came back around, because every once in a while there's a show that kind of disappears into the ether and then it comes back around a few years later. But it's very rare that we dub those shows, so I was very excited that we got to dub this one.
Excellent. From Anmas, what's your favorite quirk about Nano? Personally, I love how seriously she takes parenting Kakasa. So precious.
So precious. I love their relationship. She is so patient with Hakase. Hakase, let's be real. She can be like an actual child. She can be a spoiled little brat sometimes. But Nano never lets it get to her. She's just kind of like, it's okay. It's going to be fine. You just go sit over there and be quiet and everything's going to be all right. You know? Like, she's just so chill. And that's something I don't have in my own life. Like, if I lived with a Hakase, I would probably, like, chuck her out the front door and be like, have fun! But for Nano, she's so patient with her and so lovely with her, and that is adorable. I think for me, though, one of my favorite things is the fact that she doesn't have 100% control of her body and what happens. So those little moments, like I was talking about earlier, when her hand will shoot off, or she'll go to reach for something and, you know, her arm explodes or whatever, and her reaction to that. Most of us, I think, if we were in a situation where we had a big wind on the back or our arm exploded, we'd freak out. She's just like, okay, this is my life. Let's move on and hope it doesn't happen again. She's just like an eternal optimist, and I absolutely love that about her. Questions, you guys?
This is from Goyo. This is like one of my friends in Mexico. What was your favorite scene to voice act, and why?
Gosh, you guys, there's so many great scenes. I think one of my favorite scenes, though, is when they bring Sakamoto home and he starts talking and they're like, that one was fun. Oh, gosh, there's so many. I love the shopping episode when they're out shopping. Just really any time that they're Hakase and Nana are in her, the little songs. Oh my gosh, you guys. We had so much fun doing the little scene cuts for the commercial breaks, you know, with the rock, paper, scissors and all that. So much fun. So I don't know that I could think of any one particular moment. Just the entire show as a whole, we just had a blast. There were so many giggles happening between, because Jade played Hakase, but she was also the director. So we would just giggle about stuff, and sometimes she would read live with me as we're recording. It's just a really great experience all the way around. All the way around.
This is from Lucky. Hello, have you met the original voices of the anime? What was it like working on the dubbing? Greetings from Mexico.
Hey, Mexico! I wish I could go to Mexico right now. I wish I could go anywhere right now. I have not met any of the voice actors for nichijou. It's really interesting because we do get to meet our counterparts at conventions usually, but for some reason I'm never at the conventions where my counterparts are. I've met three, but none of them are from nichijou. I met a counterpart for Angelic Layer, which is an old show. The young lady that played Tamayo in Japanese, we got to have lunch, kind of talk about the process of dubbing, which was cool. I've met the voice of Sakura from Tsubasa briefly. I got to introduce her before a concert, so it was kind of like, hi, yay! And then my counterpart in an OVA called Girl Power. Those are the only three that I've gotten to meet. I would love to meet more, and I would love to be able to sit down and talk with them and be like, okay, so how did you do this? And this is how we do it. And the dubbing processes are so different, because in Japan, they record as a group. So you have a bunch of voice actors in a studio and maybe a couple of mics, and then you walk up with your your stuff, and you go and you record your line. And when it's your turn, and then when your scene's over, you go back and sit down. And when I was talking to one of the seiyuu about how we do it, he's explaining, well, you know, we go in individually because we have to match the flaps. You know, we don't change the animation at all. So it's easier and better time-wise to have each person come in individually. And the seiyuu was horrified. She said, you don't have anybody with you? It's just you? I'm like, yeah, that's how it works. She's like, that's so weird. Well, we're just used to it. So with nichijou, it was nice, though, having Jade, who also played Hakase, because then I had my counterpart there, and we could read lines together while recording, which was cool. But that's not always the case. Usually it's just you by yourself, and then kind of like a puzzle, you know, they put in one voice, and then another voice, and then another voice until the whole thing is done. That's why you really lean on your director to know what's going on. So it was nice to have a director that not only knew the story, but was actually a part of the story as well. But yeah, it's a really fun, interesting process. Like, I'd really love to cover more behind the scenes stuff eventually, like once I actually do the social media thing again. Then I would love to cover more of it, because it really is a cool process, and I think that we don't spend enough time, you know, explaining to you guys what it looks like, because it is really, really weird and cool.
Yeah.
Good question.
Yeah, actually, did you know that Nano's voice actress from Japan, she's a YouTuber now?
Oh, I didn't know that!
Oh, maybe after this I will send you a link. Because she just started doing like lots of vlogs.
I have no idea.
Yeah, it's really cool.
How cool!
So,
I just met on Instagram. I was just followed by, I guess, I don't even know what language she speaks, but she's the dub actress for another character that I play in a show called Signsgate, and we share a character, and she got in touch with me on Instagram. I'm like, this is cool. So now we have dub actors from all different languages hanging out.
That's neat. Just imagine like a last supper with all of the sayings and all.
All of the nanos. Yeah. Yeah, I would love a link, because I'd love to check out her YouTube. That would be awesome.
Yeah. Let's go for the next question. This is from Specific Stats. If given the option, do you think it'd be fun to recreate the character songs in English, too? I don't know if you know about the character songs.
It's a whole disc, right, of other, or another LP, I guess, of character songs based on characters.
Yeah, Nano has
I would love to do something. Really? No, this has been a thing since the beginning. Like, you know, there's a lot of shows that have kind of their own, like, character stories or character songs or whatever that are released on separate DVDs or CDs and stuff. We've always wanted to do those. Like, there's always been this question of, can we do those too? Can we do those too? But unfortunately, it's hard to get the rights to do that. So I would love to, but I don't know that we're gonna be able to. That's a problem. Licensing is weird.
it's really fucking weird.
Oh, I lost. Anyway, let me grab. I'm gonna turn you up real quick. I just lost my headphones.
Oh yeah, that's why you cut off. You cut off for a bit.
Can you hear okay?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Awesome. Cool. So we'll ditch these guys.
So we keep going?
Yes.
Okay. This is for me. This is the most important question from all the presentation. I need you to tell me, what's better, milk chocolate or dark chocolate?
Amy's over here like, what a horrible question. How am I supposed to choose? So, this is just me. This is not Nano. This is just me. Dark chocolate.
Hell yeah. Good to know. Good to know.
A good one? Okay, good.
good.
I'm weird. I love dark chocolate, especially when it's combined with fruit. So, like, if you get, like, dark chocolate and raspberries or dark chocolate strawberries, that is my jam. 100%. Milk chocolate, I mean, it's okay, but I want to taste the chocolate, not the milk. You know?
You have more haters now. You did this to yourself.
I know, right? Between this and the Choco Mint stuff debacle from Uzuki, people are like, ew, I'm like, Choco Mint's good, y'all. I don't know what your problem is. But I love dark chocolate. Sorry, guys.
Let's go for the next one. This is from Sakin Nagaman. He was actually really excited to come here, but because of the user limit, he's not here, so he's very sad right now. But let's try and
answer his question.
Okay, so he says, who do you think is the best scientist out of the two of them, Hakase or Bulma? I've been making a Dragon Ball X nichijou fan comic lately, and those kinds of questions pop up in my head a lot. So I was really interested hearing your thoughts on this silly question of mine. I hope you have a wonderful day.
Hope you have a wonderful day as well. Oh my goodness, who would be a better... Ooh. I mean, Hakase's creations and inventions are awesome. A little wacky, right? They're a little different. Whereas I'd say Bulma's are probably a little more practical. You know, like she's going to give you a house that pops up out of a little capsule. Or she's going to give you a time machine. Whereas Hakase is going to give Nano an arm that shoots fireworks. You know? Still great inventors, but one a little more practical than the other. I would say if the two of them teamed up together, that's when you get the gold. Because you have the practicality and then you have the whimsical. You put those two together and they're probably unstoppable. But I think that the two of them would probably clash quite a bit because their personalities are both very strong and very different. So I don't know if Bulma and Hakase hanging out would be a good thing, except that Bulma would definitely baby Hakase. She would take care of her and be like, oh, you precious little angel. So yeah, I guess I could see them teaming up someday. That's a good question. I definitely think that the two of them together would be even better than either or.
All right. Let's go for the next one. Jack Vanny says, if you got the chance to do a voice in the anime again, would you want to go with the same character or try someone else? If you went with the same character, would you do anything differently than last time?
Questions, you guys. I would want to play Nano again, period. I had so much fun, and she is just the sweetest, most awesome character. I've never had a character that I've wanted to just reach out and hug so much. You know, you're like, oh, everything's gonna be okay. I adore, as far as like going back and changing anything, I would say that what I would change is I'd want to have the knowledge of the character that I had at the end of the show in the beginning of the show. I think for all of us voice actors, what's hard is the first few episodes, you're really just kind of learning the character. You're figuring out what they're sounding like and, okay, what does it sound like when they scream? What does it sound like when they laugh? What does it sound like when they cry? Like, you have to figure all that stuff out. So it's kind of like a toddler learning to walk. It's not always the most stable. Then by the time you get into like the fourth and fifth episode, you really hit your stride and you know that character inside and out, and it's so much more seamless. So I think that the thing that I would want to change would be to have the knowledge of having already recorded the show in its entirety and be able to start from the beginning knowing what I know now. I think that would be really cool. But I would definitely be not.
The bad pilot says, what was it like recording? What was the schedule like? I think that's how you pronounce it.
Good question, too. So recording, what's interesting is now that we're doing simuldubs, it's a little different. So back in the day, you would get, like Funimation would get, say, a 12 episode show for the season. Then what they would do is go, okay, Monica, you're playing the main character. You are going to need 38 hours for the entirety of the show. And then they would say, this needs to be done in the next 2 months. So you would take the 38 hours and then you would split it up over 2 months worth of time. So you might have 6 hours one day, 2 hours one day, just however it works out. Now with the simuldubs, we go week to week. And even though we already had the entirety of nichijou, we still recorded it like a simuldub just to fit it into the schedule a little bit more easily. So what that meant was every week, instead of being scheduled for 6 hours or 8 hours, you're being scheduled for 2 hours, 3 hours. So there were weeks that I would come in that it would be a very heavy Nano and Hakase episode, and then I might have 3 or 4 hours, whereas the next week, Nano and Hakase wouldn't be in the forefront of the episode, so I'd only have an hour instead. So there's a lot of balancing that. What's also weird about it is that you're also working on, you know, 10 other shows at the same time. So you're going from one studio playing Nano in Nichijou, and then going over here and playing Mara Leona in Black Clover, and then going over there. So it's just this constant knowing of characters. And we have what are called reference lines. So whenever the director feels that you're the most in character, they take one of the lines from that particular clip so that before you start performing, you can listen to it, read along with it, so you make sure you're in voice. It's also how we keep track of, like, if there's a second or third season, you can always go back to those references. So that's the little tricks that we do to kind of make sure that we're staying consistent, but it's definitely harder on the simuldub schedule than it was when we would get big chunks. Definitely harder. But still totally worth it.
All right. Let's go for the next one. The Dab Driver says, where does Nano rank on your character voice acting list? Was it fun? Not as fun as... or not as fun as others.
Hey, I love this little Garfield that's at the bottom. That's so cute.
Nano Garfield.
I was like, is that a Nano? It's a Nano Garfield, and I love it.
It was our April Fool's.
I would say, was it? Oh my god, it's adorable. I love it. I would say she's way up there. It was super fun because I never knew what to expect. Nichijou is one of those shows where I knew that it was out there, like that it had been out for a while. If I wanted to watch the entirety of the show before I went in and recorded, I probably could have. But I chose not to because I had so much fun reacting in the moment, like watching it happen as Nano was watching it happen. So for that reason alone, I would say she was way high up there because you never know what to expect. You never know what's going to happen between talking cats and appendages that fly off. Like, you just never know from episode to episode what's going to happen to the poor girl. So I had so much fun, and there were so many giggles and aww between me and Jade recording Nano and Hakase. Like, we just had a blast. I would go back to that show in a heartbeat at any moment. If they were ever like, hey, there's more Nichijou, I'm there. Like, I will be there. I will camp out outside of Funimation as soon as there's no COVID. And I would be there ready to go. I love that show.
Excellent. Okay, next one. This is anonymous. Opinion on Homestuck, or have you read it?
Read it. So it's been on my list of stuff to check out since it took over cosplay at conventions, like, what, 10 years ago? Something like that. It's definitely been on my list of stuff to check out, but my list of stuff to check out is really long. That being said, some of the most interesting cosplay I've seen at conventions is Homestuck, and I can't tell you how many times I've gone up to cosplayers and been like, what is this? They're like, Homestuck. I'm like, okay, sure, whatever that is. But yeah, the cosplay, definitely. Like, there was a while there where you could not go to a convention without just legions and legions and legions of people with gray skin everywhere. And the best part was they would leave, like, you'd see handprints and stuff, and, you know, like, you could tell when they hugged someone because somebody would have, like, some gray on their shirt or whatever. But they were always fun. I do need to check it out at some point, I guess. Eventually.
Great. Bottom Control says, what about voicing Nano and Nano herself do you like the most?
Oh man, I love her optimism. I love the fact that no matter what happens to her, she just continues to go on. And, you know, she just lets things kind of roll off her back. Like, I'm not going to be bothered by it. It's okay. Life's going to be fine. Even if she doesn't really believe it all the time. She's just got this air of positivity to her, and I wish that I could be more like her in day-to-day life, like, just letting things not get to me as much, and just realizing that it's a momentary inconvenience and that things are going to be okay. She's just a sweetheart. Like, of the characters that I've voiced over the years, I look back and I'm like, who are, like, the absolute sweeties? Like, the ones that you would, like, want to take out for dessert and, like, just give them the world. And Nano is, like, way high up there. She's just the sweetest little thing ever. I love her.
Next question.
I love her so much.
Albo says, where did you study? How did you become a voice actress?
I actually had no intention of being a voice actor. It was just kind of, I was an actor. I started acting when I was 12, doing a lot of theater and some film stuff. And I went all through high school, studying theater in high school, doing plays, doing stuff outside of school. Then I went to the University of Houston and studied theater there. And actually, while I was at the University of Houston, I was doing a show called Cymbeline, which is a Shakespeare show, with a gentleman named Jason Douglas, who is an old friend of mine and an accomplished voice actor in his own right. And he told me, he's like, I'm auditioning for these cartoons. And I was very confused because I'm like, in Houston? Like, I thought all that stuff was done in LA. How are you doing that in Houston? And he explained to me, like, there's this company and they're doing these cartoons from Japan. And I'm like, anime? Like, are you talking about anime? Like, my brother loves anime. Like, are you serious? They do that here in Houston. So he gave me the number, and I called, and it just so happened to be ADB Films. And they were having auditions that weekend, and I went and auditioned, and here we are 20-some-odd years later. And I'm still doing the thing, which is crazy to me. I consider myself so lucky and so blessed to have been doing it this long and to have this much of a career, and I'm constantly getting to play new and fun characters, and it keeps me entertained. I haven't ever held a job this long because it does keep me entertained. I'm always doing something new. But yeah, I did not study to be a voice actress, just to be an actress, and I found myself voice acting. I wish somebody had told me about it a long time ago, though, because it really is a cool gig.
Next question. Yeah, she's so cute. Look at her. This is from Pastel Uni. Is there any oddities or quirks in your nichijou voice acting that most people wouldn't think of?
Oh gosh. Other than our personalities, like, voice actors are a bunch of weirdos, but we embrace the weird. There is weird stuff that you have to do that you don't normally think of as weird, but I think the general public would think of as weird. For instance, now, you know, we're recording everything at home, but back when we would go to the studio to record, like, say for nichijou, I would do vocal warm-ups on the way in the car, and then once I'm warmed up, I would turn on the radio and listen to music and sing in the character's voice. So, you know, I would be singing in Nano's voice to get into character. And you kind of forget that people are watching, you know, like when you stop at a stoplight and you're sitting there like making funny voices and warming up, and the people in the car over are like, what is that crazy woman doing there? That's weird. So that kind of stuff, you kind of forget about looking like an idiot. You just kind of look like an idiot all the time and just embrace that that's part of the job, I guess. But there's a lot of stuff that people don't think about, like having to take care of our voices. We drink a lot of room temperature water. There's a lot of having to stay away from caffeine and having to stay away from dairy and things that other people love. And I love. I love ice cream, but I can't do it because sessions. So little stuff like that that's rough. But the better, like the good part outweighs the bad and the quirky stuff. So it's not too bad. I will say, though, with anime in particular, it helps to have a background in music at some point because of the matching of the flaps. There's very much a rhythm to it, so we find that there's a lot of musically inclined people that are involved in anime dubbing. So, yeah, we're just a quirky group as a whole, honestly. We're just all a little quirky and unique and different. But good questions.
Next question. This is from Nisamu. Are you a fan of Narawi Peachy's works?
Jade and I were talking about this because the little sparrow, the little bird that he puts on everything, we started seeing that pop up everywhere. I'm like, wait, is that nichijou related? Is that nichijou related? I haven't really gotten a chance to check out any other works because with the simuldub schedule, we are literally going boom, 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 like just show up, show up, show up, show up. But trust me, it's on my list of stuff to check out because I had such a blast with nichijou. Anything and everything, now I want to consume. I want to see it all. So I will definitely be checking it out, so you'll have to let me know in the future. You would think I would have done that during pandemic, but I think everybody's just been freaking out about life.
Yeah. It's been so long, yet we're still adapting somehow. Let's go to the next question.
It's been weird. Awesome.
Yeah. This is an anonymous question. What's your favorite of the roles you played? What roles do you wish you hadn't taken?
I can't think of a role that I wish I hadn't taken. Because I like the challenge. Like, even if I'm presented with a character that I personally am like, that's a horrible person, or that's crazy, I still like the challenge of making that character a likable character. Even if I don't agree with them, or I think that they're a toxic character, I still try to find a way to make them redeemable. So I've never had one that I wish I hadn't taken. Now, there are some etchy shows that I've been a part of that I'm like, ooh, it would have been nice to be a part of that, but whatever. Not my problem. But some of the favorite roles, like, this is where it gets hard. I was just telling Amy earlier, like, this is the hardest question because every time I start thinking about it, it's like they start, all the characters, I see them in my head, like, pick me, and then I feel really bad if I don't pick. But I've been very lucky to get to play such a wide variety of characters. Of course, like, the roles that you spend the most time with, so, like, your Bulmas, so you love Sweet, but like, you're like an idiot. Marileona and Sepha from Black Clover, characters that you, Mara Jane from Fairy Tail, those guys, of course you have a relationship with because, you know, I've been doing those for years. Then besides those guys, you have your sweethearts, the characters that you just wish were a part of your family, like Nano, oh my gosh, there's so many. And then there's the fun ones, like I think of Stocking from Panty and Stocking, and even though I would never want to hang out with her, she's still so much fun. I've told people, I'm like, if I could have a party where all of my characters were there, like, that would just make me so happy, because what a weird group of people. They'd probably all start fighting, but it'd be nice for that little 5 minutes before they started fighting to just be like, yeah, y'all are all so cool and weird. I love it.
What about ghost stories, though?
Yes, Momoko! She would be... she'd be fun to hang out with, but she'd be interesting to hang out with. Because you know it's all going to come back to Jesus at some point. But, you know, she's an interesting character, that's for sure.
All right, next question. This is like a lot of questions from the same guy. So this is from Central Centerfield. So let's go one by one. Were you given any special direction regarding Nano's voice, characterization, or mannerisms?
Can't think of anything in particular other than just she's a sweetheart, and you know, we always watch the Japanese, so when we dub, the way that we go about it is we watch each scene in Japanese first so that you get a feel of the character and what's going on in the scene, and then we go back in line by line and fill in the English. So I can't think of anything off the top of my head that Jade had, like, any direction off the top of my head that she'd given me in particular. I think pretty much most of it just came from watching the Japanese and seeing how the Seiyu reacted, and then kind of using that in my own way. I just remember that everything was about being very, very sweet. So there was a couple of times where Nano would kind of snap at Hakusei, and Jade's like, can we make that sweeter? I know you're angry, but maybe a sweeter angry? Okay, yeah, sure. There might have been a little Bulma that came out every just because she's so used to yelling at me. But good question. That's awesome.
Let's go for the next one. What was the production of the dub like? Is there any interesting trivia about the process you could share?
Ooh, okay, so it's one of the simuldubs. So it wasn't necessarily, we didn't have to do it simuldub style. Like I said, we had the entirety of the show, but to fit it into the schedule, the easiest way to do that was to do like one episode a week. And while that's fun, it is kind of awful when the episode ends on a cliffhanger and you have to wait the next week to come in to record to figure out what's going on about that. So that was a little bit difficult. It was a lot of fun watching people like crossing on nichijou. Like you would leave and somebody else would be coming in. I would see Leah Clark a lot. I'd see Morgan Garrett. And we'd talk about the show because we never, like Nano and Hakase, we never really mixed until the very end of the show with the other schoolgirls. So in the beginning, I'm like, what are you guys doing? How's your nichijou going? This is how mine's going. So it was neat to have those moments and crossing in the hall and talking about the show and having two totally different experiences. I can't think of any, the only trivia I can think of to say is that Jade, who played Hakase, was also the director. And Anthony Bowling, who played Sakamoto, is another director at Funimation. And so I got to give him some flack because he seems to always be, whenever we're in shows together, he tends to be my mascot or my friend. Like I was talking about Urahara, he played my little shrimp buddy, Eddie Faraya. So poor guy is just destined to be my house pet, I guess. Sorry, Anthony.
Since COVID is preventing any anime conventions from happening, are you willing to do mail-in signatures?
In fact, there is two different ways that you can reach me. If you guys are in the States, it's called the Voice Actor Store. And Jamie Markey was like, hey, you know what? Let's put some stuff up there and see if people are interested. So if you go to the Voice Actor Store, you can find a whole bunch of different voice actors. There's me and J. Michael Tatum and Jamie, Chris Weykamp, and just a whole bunch of guys. And we've got all kinds of stuff up there. There's not a nichijou print because I haven't been to conventions, so I haven't been doing a lot of new prints. But if you guys have a request, you can always put in a request and we'll find the best picture that we can and do it that way. If you are outside of the United States or if you have something that you want to send in to be signed, there is a service called VShout. And VShout allows you to either send in your merchandise to be signed and then have it sent back to you, or to purchase something through their site and have it signed. But with VShout, you also get a little video message from me as I'm signing your stuff, and they do international shipping. So the Voice Actor Store only does local, domestic stuff, but then VShout, you can be anywhere in the world and get your stuff signed. So.
He says, thank you for taking the time to answer everyone's questions today.
Oh, of course! I'm so happy to get to talk with you guys. This has been awesome. Y'all have great questions. I'm actually having to think.
I don't know if there's more. Let me see. Okay, here's the one that we talked before starting this. Say, you will be terminated and I'll be back as Nano, please.
We'll be terminated. I'll be back.
Thank you.
We love her so much. I would go back and work on this show in a heartbeat. Oh my goodness.
I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm going to say Ertisha Effendi. Can you tell me who is your favorite teacher in nichijou? What do you like and don't like about him/her?
Gosh, I honestly am blanking. I don't even know if I can remember the teachers right now. Because I spend so much time, like I spent the whole time wanting to go to school, and then by the time I went to school, I think I just got so excited about going to school, I forgot all about the teachers. So I'm not sure. You'll have to get back to me on that one. I'll have to go rewatch the show and remind myself of the teachers, because I don't remember. I'm an old. And we're in the middle of a pandemic.
A very busy one, too.
Oh my gosh, yeah, yeah, there's been so much anime between nichijou and now that my brain is like, I think I remember the teachers, but is that nichijou? Or is that another anime that I'm not supposed to talk about yet? It's so confusing.
Okay. let's go for the next one. Fry Guy says, do you animate or draw anything yourself?
That is one thing I cannot do. I wish I could draw. I used to doodle a lot when I was younger, thinking maybe someday, and I do still like to paint. I'm just not, it's more like just very abstract throwing things that it's not really painting. I don't have a very good eye for that. I'm a dancer, I'm a singer, I'm an actor, but when it comes to like visualization and taking like a thing and being able to like paint it, that escapes me. But I am so amazed by all of your talent. Like every time somebody brings me something at a convention and shows me their work, I'm like, how do you do that? I don't understand. It's just not something that computes with me, but I wish I could. Maybe someday I'll take some classes, but I'm not very good at it.
I think this is the last one. This is from Domo and Finch. Can you imitate the other Nietzsche characters' voices?
I don't know that I could. I know there's one thing that I always used to love that Hakase would do. Nano! That was my favorite. That is the only thing I could probably imitate. I cannot imitate Morgan or Leah. Leah's voice is so different and quirky. But I can do the Nano. That's about it. Oh, the rest of them, I'm such a bad mimic. I'm one of those people that I try to mimic, and then my mimic ends up sounding like a completely different thing altogether. So I usually go to my friends, and I'm like, okay, can I sound like this person? And then I try to sound like them. It sounds nothing like them, but it'll be another character in an anime. It'll be my interpretation of. But yeah, I'm not a very good mimic.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go for the next one. Johnny says, not nichijou related. What's it like working on Saga of Tanya the Evil? Any idea when if ever the movie will be done?
Saga of Tanya the Evil is a great show. It is the antithesis of nichijou. Like, nichijou is light and airy and friendly, and Saga of Tanya the Evil is dark and awful and depressing, but in the best way. I absolutely loved playing Tanya. In fact, these two shows kind of overlapped a little bit, if I remember correctly. There might have been Isekai, but either way, the character overlapped a little bit. But I love playing Tanya because she is so awful, and yet she thinks she's doing the right thing. So she doesn't even realize that she's the villain in her own show. And that's what makes her the most interesting, I think. As far as the movie, I don't know if it'll be dubbed. I promise you that Jeremy Inman, the director of Tanya, and I have been at Funimation like, hey, don't forget about the movie. Especially now, because it seems like Sony's this giant anime umbrella in the United States now that it seems like maybe... now that we are under the same umbrella as Crunchyroll, which owned the movie rights, that maybe we will have the opportunity to do that now. I think it's good that she's in Isekai Quartet still, so it makes me think, well, if she's still there, then hopefully maybe there'll be some more of it in the future. Who knows, but I would love to go back to that show as well. I want to see the movie. I haven't seen it yet. I keep holding out, you know, hoping that we'll get to dub it, but who knows? Here's hoping.
Okay, Linky says, do you prefer Nano's hair with or without twin tails?
I'm gonna say without, just because that's the Nano that I'm the most familiar with, is without the twin tails. I think she's adorable. And I love the key on her back, and I hope she never gets rid of it. I think everything about her whole design is just chef's kiss.
Conan says, Thoughts on Haruna Anaka, one of the side characters from nichijou.
That's one of the things that's so cool about nichijou is that all of the side characters kind of have their own world and their own lives going on. I love that you saw the same side characters in, going throughout the show. I just think they were all so well written and well rounded, because usually when you have like secondary and tertiary characters or side characters like that, they don't usually get to have much of a personality, or they don't really have much going for them other than like they're just there to move the story along. But in nichijou, all of the side characters kind of got their chance to shine. You know, they had their moment. There was something about them that made them stand out, and I think that's definitely true of Haruna and of all of them. Like, they all kind of had their little moment to shine, and they were much more interesting than most side characters would be. So I have to say that nichijou definitely had that going for it. Definitely. All the characters were fun.
Okay, I think this is the last one. This is from... No, never mind. There's one more. I forget. James says, how was it like working with the rest of the cast?
Working with the cast is awesome. Now, it is weird because, like I said earlier, we go in individually, so you never really get to see the entirety of the cast together, which is strange, I know, but that's just how we do it. But, like I said, Jade, who plays Hakase, was the director, so it was nice being able to, like, read in real time. Like, sometimes I'd be in the booth and she would read her lines so that we could have that whole scene together. And then Anthony and I definitely would run around Funimation being silly, with him as Sakamoto and me as Nano being kind of ridiculous and poking fun at other people and stuff. So yeah, but all of the entire cast of that show are great. I would love to, you know, hang out with them and do an nichijou panel sometime, like all of us together. I think that would be really, really cool. So that might have to be something once conventions come back. Something that I suggest is like, hey, let's start doing some nichijou stuff. I think, unfortunately, it gets forgotten sometimes because it was out for such a long time before we actually dubbed it, that I think it kind of floats under the radar a little bit. So we'll have to pull it out of the water and be like, hey, guys, watch the show. Here's
that would be great. It would be great to have a panel. Holy shit.
Yeah, I'll have to talk to the others and be like, hey, once conventions start up again, let's make this happen.
Right. Okay. Snoofy Lufikas says, would you want to voice Nano again if Assistant Chew was ever made?
100%, yes. I would go back in a heartbeat. I love the show. I love that it's a show that I can also, like, suggest to my friends that have kids. Because sometimes, you know, with anime, you go, oh, yeah, watch Fairy Tail. Oh, wait, there's a bunch of bikini girls. Or, oh, watch this. Oh, no. This is one show that I can actually tell my friends with kids, like, oh, it's safe for them to watch. And it's just a fun show. It doesn't matter if you're a child, if you're an adult. Like, it's just entertaining and fun and wholesome. And I absolutely love it. So, yeah, I would be there in a heartbeat. I would be super excited to play Nano again.
Great. This is from Snake. Did you watch the anime before voicing over it? If so, what were your first impressions of nichijou like?
Did it beforehand, because I think sometimes if we watch it ahead of time, it can help, and then sometimes it actually causes some foreshadowing. Like, you don't even realize that you're kind of giving away little tidbits in your reads and stuff. So I tried not to watch it. When we went in, I also liked reacting the way that Nano would react. So, like, you know, her hand would shoot off and it's this, oh my god, did that really just happen? So it was more of a natural reaction instead of me pretending to react to something. And to me, I like that. I like trusting my instincts and going about it that way. I will tell you that as soon as I saw the show, I absolutely fell in love with it. I love the art style. I love the comedy. I love the dry humor in it. But yeah, I did not watch it ahead of time because I wanted to experience life as not an experience.
Oh, I think I posted this one again. I'm sorry. I think, yeah, it's the same question. Whoopsies, not professional. Okay,
no, you're good.
We just got to the end. Those are all of the questions. Some of the artists in the server sent me like some art that they wanted you to see. So let's get through it if you feel like it. Okay, the first one. This is from Shoki.
It's crazy. That looks like a still.
Whoa. What have I done with my life?
He was like, what am I doing with my life, right? Exactly. I can't do that. I couldn't even trace that. There's no way. That is awesome.
Okay, the next one. This is from Snowy Cat.
You know what's funny is this reminds me. Totally unrelated, but I was in a show way back in the day called Azumanga Daioh, and I played a character named Niamo, the gym teacher. And
Join
so,
Ramo?
yeah,
Yo!
so there's Nano kind of reminded me of baby Niamo, right? So it's fun to see her in the basketball costume because I'm like, oh my gosh, it's like she is baby Niamo. That is so cute. And the basketball's in motion. How do y'all are like magicians?
They are incredible, yeah.
I can't do any of
Okay, let's go for the
that.
next one. This is by Hen, one of the moderators.
Oh, they look like little peeps. I must be hungry or sugar or something because I'm like, peeps! No, they look adorable. That is so cute. Y'all are all so good.
Okay, here's the next one. This is Ultra Instinct Nano.
There's a crossover for you. I love it. That is awesome. I love all the colors in the background. Super cool.
And there's one more from the same artist. This is a Dragon Ball crossover with Nano.
That's adorable. Oh my gosh, you guys. That is the crossover I never knew I needed. Dragon Ball and nichijou. Like, I never even thought of a crossover for those two, but oh my gosh, that's adorable. That is adorable.
All right.
So
Okay.
cute.
And with this, this is how we conclude. I just really want to say, like, this has been like since August, or God knows how long I've been trying to pester your entire team to get you. So,
We've just been like so overwhelmed. So thank you for being so
yeah.
patient.
Yeah, thank you so much. Like, this was like really fun. You were so supportive with everything. Like, this was really fun. I with my heart. Thank you. Thank
No, you
you.
guys are great. Oh gosh, thank you so much. Y'all have been amazing, and I'm so glad that there is a nichijou community of people that have seen the show and love it as much as we do, because it's one of those shows that you're like, you don't want it to go away. I want to make sure that people are still watching it and enjoying it. So I'm so glad that you guys do. So much love to all of you. I gotta run, but it was so nice talking to you, and hopefully I'll see you guys at convention. Mucho gusto.
Hey.
Take care of yourself. All of y'all be safe out there, please.
Thank you so much.
Bye,
Thank you
guys.
for everything. Bye.
Thank you.
That's it. Thank you everyone for coming. This was really fun. And well, this is really it. See y'all.